And you're showing off, but it's alright. And you're showing off, but it's alright. It's a short life. Right, so welcome back to the channel, guys. My name is Raihan. I'm a third year medical student and I make YouTube videos. Now, I don't usually do review videos of products, but a lot of people have just received their medical school offers and they're about to go on to medical school. So I thought I'd release a video to outline how to pick a budget stethoscope to take to medical school with you. Before I start this video, I want to say a big thank you to Medishop XL for providing me with these stethoscopes. I only have two stethoscopes and they're both the same model, which means that this video would have been useless. Before I go ahead with the video, I just want to say that I'm going to do a stethoscope giveaway because now I've got five different stethoscopes and I don't really need all five of them. So if you want to get involved in this giveaway, then make sure you follow me on Instagram and Snapchat, where I'll be mentioning how you can get involved in this giveaway and other competitions that I'm going to be running this year. Other competitions include and I'm gonna think of a few more competitions, but for now, just them. So yeah, make sure you find us on Instagram and Snapchat and you can get involved in these competitions. So now let's start with the actual video. Let me give you a quick guide onto what are the different parts that you have in a stethoscope and what they do, basically. So to start off with, this is the head of the stethoscope, and here we have the smaller side of the stethoscope. This is called a bell, and here we have the diaphragm. The diaphragm picks up the higher frequencies, the bell picks up the lower frequencies. Now, by higher frequencies, what I mean is your heart sounds, your breathing sounds. These are your higher frequencies, and the bell picks up things like the Korotkov sounds when you're measuring blood pressure or heart murmurs. To switch between the sides, you twist the tube like this. And you know, you can pick which side you want to listen with. The second part of the stethoscope is a tube. The tube is very important because this is what will conduct all the sound to your ears. I've used a couple of cheap stethoscopes and I've noticed that the tubes either crack or they don't conduct the sound that well. The more expensive stethoscopes have two tubes inside them. So this is why finding a stethoscope made of PVC plastic tubing is very important to make sure that you're hearing the sounds clearly and loud. The final part of the stethoscope is this. This is the bit that you put inside your ear, and you know, what can I say? There's not really much to say about this other than the fact that you put it inside your ear. So yeah, in terms of the weight, right, there's going to be a bit of a compromise. So you either pick a heavy stethoscope, which is good quality with stainless steel or titanium, which will conduct the sound very well and will last a very long time, or you pick a cheap stethoscope, which is, you know, it won't be as hard on your shoulders when, because if you think of it, you're going to be walking around many hours of the day, many hours of the week with a stethoscope on your neck. And you don't want a heavy, if you don't want a heavy stethoscope, then you might want to go for a cheaper option, a cheaper stethoscope, which isn't made with titanium or stainless steel, but it won't give you shoulder pains. Or you can just go to the gym, work on your shoulders, and then do shoulder shrugs. So, in terms of the sound with all of these three stethoscopes, in my opinion, I found both of the Lippmanns were more or less the same. The Schweitzer wasn't as good. Now, this is the cheaper option, and I'm not surprised because the sound that I got with this was a bit lower than the two Lippmann stethoscopes, and it wasn't as clear. The Lippmann Classic 3 had a loud and it was clear sound quality. Second was the Lippmann Classic 2. And there wasn't much of a difference between the Classic 3 and the Classic 2 in terms of sound quality, but there was a big difference between the Lippmanns and the Schweitzer. The Schweitzer wasn't as good in terms of picking up heart sounds. You do have to ask the patient to hold their breath in for long times so you can make sure you can, you know, pick up that heart sound. And if you've got a patient with COPD and you're telling them to take a deep breath in and hold it, it's not really comfortable for them. So in my opinion, that's why I recommend the Lippmann Classic 2 and Classic 3, because, you know, it does pick it up a lot louder and a lot clearer than the Schweizer. So, in terms of sound, number one is the Lippmann Classic 3, number two was the Lippmann Classic 2, and in final place is your Schweizer Classic stethoscope, unfortunately. Now, in terms of tubing, so here I have the three different tubes, and out of the three tubes, the Schweizer was probably my least favorite because it bends very easily. Now, this isn't a good sign because if a tubing bends easily, then it's obviously not that thick material. The quality of the material isn't as good, and it explains why it wasn't that good at conducting the sound. However, the Lippmann Classic 2 was a lot thicker and a lot harder to bend. The best of all three of them is by far the Lippmann Classic 3. This is a very thick tube. It's a lot harder to bend, and it explains why the sound quality was superior to the other two. In terms of tubing, number one is your Lippmann Classic 3. Number two was the Lippmann Classic 2. And number three, unfortunately, again in last place, is your Schweizer stethoscope. Finally, we have the earpieces. So, in terms of earpieces, right, the most comfortable, in my opinion, was surprisingly the Schweizer stethoscope. So, the Schweizer stethoscope has a very thin, comfy material, which you can put in your ear, and it's quite small as well, so it fits in to more or less any ear size. And with it being thin, it's quite comfortable on inside your ear. However, with the Lippmann stethoscopes, they're quite thick material, and they are quite hard. They're not as soft as the Schweizer when you press on them. And when you put it in your ear, it's not painful now, but I've used these for quite a while when you're doing examinations. And if you have them in for more than 5 minutes or even more than a minute, you start to feel a little bit of a pain in your ear, and it does start to get uncomfortable. So in terms of earpieces, number one is the Schweizer, surprisingly. Number two was the Lippmann Stethoscope Classic 3. And in third place is your Lippmann Classic 2. However, there's something that I need to mention. Now, all three of the stethoscopes came with extra ear pieces. So if you do find it uncomfortable with the Lippmann Classic 2 and the Lippmann Classic 3, then you can replace the ear pieces. They do have, well, they gave an extra pair, and with the Lippmann Classic 3, they gave a piece of plastic, right? And look how hard it is. Like, it doesn't even bend. It's not even it is plastic, but look. So like, if you thought the other piece was quite hard, well, imagine that in your ear. So to summarize, I would recommend, in my opinion, the Lippmann Classic 3 because it performed a lot better in terms of sound, and the tubing is a lot better quality. It's a lot thicker, it's a lot more conductive. However, the only downfall to that is the earpiece isn't as comfortable as the Schweizer. So I would still recommend the Schweizer if you're on a budget. It is good. It's a lot better than the cheap stethoscopes that you can buy from eBay or Amazon. But if you want to spend that bit extra, number one, get the Lippmann Classic 3. Number two, get the Lippmann Classic 2. And number three, get the Schweizer. So those three are my top recommendations for budget stethoscopes. Anyways, thank you for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Again, if you want to buy your stethoscope, make sure you check out Medishop XL, also known as Stethoscope Shop. I'll put my discount code up there as well. And yeah, well done on getting your offer for medical school. Thanks for watching. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And bye for now.